In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the Fabfilter Pro Q3 EQ. This is by far my favorite EQ, and here's why. It has a lot of good features packed into it, like mid-side processing, dynamic EQ, and so on. This newest version even has surround support up to Dolby Atmos. In short, there's very little this EQ cannot do. So let's dive right into it and look at some of the core features this plugin has to offer. When you load up the Fabfilter Pro Q3, this is how it looks. You can resize it to whatever size you want or choose from the menu here. It can even be set to full screen mode, which can be useful when you want to make very precise surgical cuts, for example. Before we dive into the new functionality, let me just quickly show you some of the core functions of this EQ and what it can do. One of the things I like about this EQ is that everything is so intuitive. The placement of each button and every menu is carefully thought out in order to provide the fastest workflow possible. You can just double-click near the low or high end, for example, and it will make a low or high cut for you. You have all the usual settings for controlling the slopes and curves, of course, and this allows you to make all kinds of crazy shapes ideal for sound design. All bands have slope settings up to 96 dB per octave. Low and high cut filters can now go even steeper with the new brick wall filter, which actually sounds surprisingly natural. There's also a new flat tilt, which can come in handy if you just want to make a sound brighter or warmer without messing up the main character of the sound itself. In addition to this, you can split the various bands into mid-side, right, left, and so on. If you want to make subharmonics mono, for example, you can do this directly in the EQ. Down here, you have the various processing modes. Here's the gain controls. There's an option for automatic makeup gain, which can be extremely helpful because it automatically compensates for any EQ settings so that the overall volume remains the same. Let me show you an example. Here's how it would sound without the automatic makeup gain. Notice how the overall sound increases when I do this? Now, did this make the sound better or just louder? Human hearing is far from perfect, so this can easily fool you into thinking that you've made the right decision, because louder always sounds better to humans. Now, let's try to enable the automatic makeup gain and try this again. The overall volume stays the same. This will make it much easier to determine if your EQing actually makes the sound better or not, because you're not fooled by the volume simply getting louder. So this is definitely a feature I recommend using. Another very popular feature in Pro Q is its ability to solo a part of the spectrum. This is extremely useful when hunting for problem areas in a mix, like when trying to identify a nasty resonant frequency, for example. To do this, just click on this headphone icon. You can then move it around to hone in on the frequency. Just use the mouse wheel to make it wider or narrower. This can, of course, also be helpful when you want to identify which frequency to boost, like when you want a pluck to stand out in the mix, for example, but you just want to boost the main body of that sound. If you want to adjust more than one band at a time, you can simply drag to select the ones you want and then make your adjustments. There's also plenty of useful presets to choose from. This is extremely useful if you want to EQ a sound to make it more in tune with the key of a track, like a kick, for example. You can then easily reduce any resonant frequency that is not in the scale. You can also use it to boost the notes you do want to come through, like the root note, for example. This is a trick often used on sub-basses. You can always look up the frequencies of various notes online, of course, but this just makes it much easier to do it on the fly, allowing you to save some time. If you want more precision, just hover over the keys and use the scroll wheel to zoom in or out. You can also type in frequencies manually. To do that, double-click on any point, and then type in the exact frequency. In Pro Q3, you can use the EQ match feature to automatically create corrective EQ curves. If you use Pro Q3 on all your mixer tracks, you can now also superimpose the spectrum of any other track onto the current analyzer window and use that as a reference. It will automatically name them after the name of the track, but you can also manually change the name here if you want. This feature can be extremely beneficial when trying to pinpoint phasing or clashing issues, for example. Or perhaps you're having problems trying to get your vocals to punch through the mix because they seem to be drowned out slightly by the leads. In that case, you can superimpose the frequency of the leads to see where the frequencies are building up. You can also use the headphone icon to determine where the main body of the vocals reside, and then make surgical cuts in the leads to let the vocal through in those key areas. This is much easier than constantly going back and forth between EQs. You can also use the dynamic EQ feature. Great when you want to have total control of your kick and bass, for example. There's a lot of possibilities here. The most exciting new feature is probably the dynamics. All gain knobs now have a ring around them that you can use to set the range. Here we have a low shelf. If I turn it down, it will now compress the low end, as well as boosting it. You can also drag up and down here to adjust the range. What would normally require two or more plugins can now be done in the EQ directly. You can use both downwards and upwards compression. This is designed to be an enhancement of the EQ functionality and allows you to do on-the-fly adjustments directly in the EQ. Unfortunately, you can't adjust the attack, release, or threshold though. This is set automatically, so if you want that real fine control, you would still need to use a dedicated multiband compressor instead. That said, the algorithm is quite good and works very well for the most part. In terms of CPU consumption, it's basically the same as in the previous versions. The exception is when using the new dynamics features and such, which will of course require more processing power, but that has to be expected. There's a lot more to this plugin that I haven't covered yet, such as sidechain functionality and other items. But I'll cover that in another video. These are some of the core functions that I think are most important. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell if you want to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.